Mr. Moholy-Nagy, what is your attitude toward art today? I do not believe so much in art as in mankind. Every man reveals himself. Much of it is art.
One of the most remarkable artists of the century, certainly one of the great teachers of our time.
Moholy did almost everything.
Photography, typography, theater.
He was very radical and groundbreaking. And he really put into question, what is art?
It says, butcher in Marseille, very Moholy.
My father decided to become an artist after the war. He landed in Berlin, and then he met Gropius and went to the Bauhaus. All this stuff was like exploding, and my dad was right in the middle of it.
But this idea of modernism was absolutely unwelcome in Nazi Germany.
You make abstract art not because it looks pretty. You make abstract art because you want to change the world.
The Association of Arts and Industries in Chicago said, we need a school like the Bauhaus in Germany.
So my dad accepted the job, and they called it the new Bauhaus, American School of Design.
Moholy's approach was to get people to look again with the eyes of a child.
This was a German Bauhaus exercise to cultivate your sense of touch.
They cared about the process and the act of creation and making something new.
It's constantly veined with joy.
One of the most ubiquitous products that came out of the school was the Honey Bear.
You had someone like first designer of Playboy magazine.
Its name is Dove.
When the students graduated, they went all over the country teaching the ID philosophy.
Moholy's almost 10 years in Chicago were absolutely foundational for the history of 20th century art.
For Moholy-Nagy, the whole artistic practice was one of societal importance. And this totally influenced me a lot.
I looked into Moholy's thinking. Process is the most important thing. We grow as we make art.